sacred words. Ooh, pussies too. That's ooh, fortitude. Hey, it worked. Hello, everybody. My name is JP Finch 1. Welcome back to Let's Attempt Kid Icarus. In the last part, we finished Underworld 1-1 and almost got past Underworld 1-2. Sadly, I got fucked over by ice. So today, let's see if we can remedy that. Bonk! Shen mums. No match for... They were no match for your arrows. As Palutena would say. I am kind of sad that we didn't get to see a lot more of Palutena in this game. Aside from us saving her at the end, spoiler alert, because you didn't know we were gonna do that! Just get down here. The hitboxes in this game are kind of throwing me off a little bit. Oh god, one thing that I forgot to mention, I'm not going to demonstrate it because I can't anywhere on this stage or I will die. One thing that I forgot to mention, do not under any circumstances press the down button on these thinner platforms like the ice. For if you do this, you will fall through the platforms. They even try to intentionally screw you over by making you do this before you fight a Reaper, because they have a thin ice platform. But the optimal strategy is to duck so that the Reaper can't find you. But doing that makes you fall through the floor, and I'll point it out when we get there, because it's in this level. But it's ridiculous. It's stupid and dumb. Dum-dee-dum-dee-dum. You know what, the weird part about this piece of music right here, this is actually the solo and title menu theme for Uprising, but they put it in a different key. I think they might have minored it, but I'm not an official aficondo on music yet, so I wouldn't know, but they changed the key in such a way that they actually made it sound like a happier tune. I might link it in the description if I feel like it, but it's a much different tune. It's kind of creepy. Oh, it's the Black Marketeer again. Not creepy, it's easily one of the better pieces of music, and I would rather not have any other menu music given the choice, because it's such a great calming piece of music, perfect for something like Palutena's Temple, where the menu screen takes place. So I don't know, it's overall a perfect tune for the menu, ironically, considering it's a room where Pit is in some of the most danger. Holy crap, did I seriously not get hit by any of those rebets? That was amazing. I think we can actually buy a Water of Life. Oh, no. The one thing that you have to know about this room is that these guys don't actually... You can see your score there right below the total. The total is how many you've gotten overall in the game. The score below that is how many you've gotten this level. I actually have enough to get a new power-up, so if I can finish this level, I'll be golden for a new set of health bars. My endurance. But, if you notice, I'm at 11,900. Destroying these guys, if one of them would be so kind, does not result in any points. So these guys are hearts only. They give you no extra points, but they give you many more hearts for much less hassle. I wouldn't say it's exactly a pick-your-poison kind of situation, but at the same time... What?! Why did the Water of Life go away? Oh hell, I have enough for the next power-up. I'm not screwing around anymore. I gotta find that shop. Oh god! The ice physics are here. If you play your cards right, the rebets won't even see you. Get in that door! Woo! Just made it. We have everything. Oh my god. You have no idea how close that was. Because the way the ice functions in this game is what it does is it makes you slide on a very particular path and then stop after a certain distance. The 3DS version functions in more such a way where what happens is it's actual ice and damn, oh my god, his pit actually slows down like at a normal pace for ice platforming. I don't remember these enemies being here, actually. I honestly don't remember them being here. In the 3DS version, because I've played that version a lot more. One thing that I count my blessings for every day is the fact that this game doesn't have a knockback. So you can sort of strategize in that sense, and it's not like Castlevania where you really just have to pull random wins out of your ass everywhere, otherwise you're going to lose, because the game has no knockback. So if you're on thin platforms like that, and you can afford to take a hit, you can do that. So I want to, yes! God, the jump physics are even weird. Can I just say that the underworld theme is just so perfect? This is the Reaper I'm talking about right here. I have a water of life, so I should be okay. I have a bottle of life. Holy, his vision is really highly extended from the 3DS version. 3DS version, you actually have to get really close to him for him to send Reepets out. Don't squander this on Reepets, Pit. Bunk! There we go. Alright, I'm not disappointed with that. I don't think I've mentioned it because it doesn't particularly bother me for some reason, but I have to make notice of how thin these platforms are. I mean, good God. They're literally pits. One pit meter. Oh God, go in this door. Glad you came, Pit. What's the apostrophe for? Here, take this. This, ladies and gentlemen, if you notice the strength, we have one arrow. Pick this up. We now have two. Goody. So now enemies like Reapers are a lot easier to take out. I think the exit to the level is actually right up here. Wow, they function a little bit differently. Yes, we got it! We got it! We finished World 1-2! Hell yeah! And for getting, I believe, either 20,000 or 25,000, we get more health points. Oh my god! So, ladies and gentlemen, this is as far as I have ever gotten on Kid Icarus for the NES. 3D Classics version, not so much, but I have not gotten past level 3. Level 3 is quite difficult, though, in terms of where they place enemies, though. I feel like this version, if I could play the 3D Classics physics with the classic controller, I feel like this would be literally the perfect game. It just controls... I control it so much better with an actual controller than the 3DS's gamepad for some reason. The 3DS gamepad works fine, and I've gotten extremely used to that. Oh shit, I don't have a water of life. The good thing about... This is where I can actually spam the magmoos. The good thing about... I'll take a little bit of time to explain. The good thing about the... Shit, what was I gonna say? I don't know, Cap'n! I don't know what I was gonna say there. Oh, well. Oh, that's right. I thought I had something to say about the 3D Classics version as compared to this, but nope. One good thing that actually happens when you get higher hit point bars is that if you ever happen to die during a level, your HP is completely refilled. So, in other words, when I come back, I will actually have two full sections of health. Well, that was me falling through a platform like I said I wouldn't in the last part. It looked a little similar to Wizard of Oz there, I would say. Alright, let's try that again. See, we have full health now. So hopefully we can find some more magmoos and generally get more points this run. You know, maybe finish the level like you're kind of supposed to. It's just a thought. I'm noticing this too, but in this game, if you jump and fire, Pit's arrows sort of arc upward. In the 3DS Classics version, they just sort of fly. They fly straight and true, but... Huh. I'm just noticing this now for some reason. I swear to God, if the magmoo decides to come around now, my shit bricks. Gonna take care of these guys first. Any magmoos? Nope. Alright, well, I'll just take on the... I believe these guys are called Spec Noses. In Kid Icarus Uprising, for some reason, in this game, they're here to swarm you because that's their main method of attack. In Kid Icarus Uprising, they come much sparser, but they have bombs. Like, literally, they throw explosive bombs at you out of their nostrils, might I add. Which is okay. It's one of those things that just, like, it screams original Japanese. You know what I mean? Yeah, you won't get me this time, you magmoo son of a bitch. In case you haven't noticed, that red stuff's lava. It's something that's odd about lava. As you just saw there, I just kind of fell in. but I didn't take damage. The reason for this, I guess, is because Pit's damage meter is set on a timer for when he's in. There are multiple objects that act as lava. In other words, what they do is they... Pit can go into them, but I guess the way it's programmed is that a timer has to run out at certain intervals for Pit to take damage, but... Oh my god! We have just enough for that bottle. Yes! Oh, that was lucky. I can't squander this opportunity, because I'm gonna forget the next time I go through this level. I say that because I know I'm going to have to do it. Oh, shindiddles. Which way do I go? I'll let you decide which way to pick. Head left to go into the tunnel, or right to go straight to the volcano. Those of you who have played Uprising know what I'm talking about. Calm down! You're not the one who's about to be turned into a dumpling! I don't have nearly enough hearts, I'm not even gonna... Actually, one thing that's funny about the NES version with the jar rooms, if you leave, it actually shows you where the Idol of Discord was. The Idol of... I believe that's called the Idol of Misfortune or something. But if you... In the NES version, if you leave the room, it actually has the common courtesy to show you where it would have ended up. Something else that I'm noticing about the enemies here is that the Shenmums fall really slowly compared to the 3D Classics version. In the 3DS Classics version, they drop like Fox in Smash Brothers. She's like, BROOM! Oh god! Whew! Did you see me ninja that Shenmum? Shenmum? I believe that's their name. Holy crap, you guys. Holy crap! Okay. It's clear that the Underworld Forces have really stepped up their game. Something that I'm noticing about these squid enemies, in case you haven't noticed in Kid Icarus, there are multiple enemy tropes that pop up more than once, and they all activate the same way, they're just different for different stages. Why did I aim up there? Okay. I mean, I know that technically it should have looked like I was aiming up so I could have hit the enemy, but whatever. And thus goes my train of thought. But these guys that are operating under this enemy thought process, what they're doing is they're hopping a lot faster, because they just advance up the screen towards your general location. They're coming a lot harder and faster than they usually do. I don't think I mentioned this, but that harp will turn all enemies that come on screen into mallets. Mallets become useful in the fortress levels. Yeah, this is a lot harder. The enemy placement here is just evil. Dear sweet god. Why are they chasing me? Ugh. Oh, is this? Okay, I have a bottle of life, so I'll be relatively okay. Oh, it's the... Okay, it's not the room I thought I was going into. Whoops! I thought that was gonna be something else. Okay, I gotta be freaking careful with these life points. I can't hold all these life... I need to make a thing with Pit, where he has life bottles, because the thing about the water barrel is that you can hold more life bottles. I need to make that meme where it's like, I can't hold all these X's. See, I just need to make that with Pit with life bottles. I can't hold all these life bottles. I'm a bit of a fanboy when it comes to Kid Icarus, really. I'm seriously a part of the fandom to the hardcore extreme. How am I doing on... Actually, if I get lucky here, I might just get a power up. Holy crap! Did you see me? Did you see that nonsense? Oh, can you endure this harsh training? Given I don't even know the patterns for these monoliths in the NES version. What? They're easier. I think they're easier. What? What? Hold on. I seriously, like, if there were ever a time that I needed to shut up and concentrate on what I'm doing, it's right now. Yes! Hell yeah! Well done, Pit. Take your pick. So, if you manage to survive long enough in these rooms, you will be able to pick from one of three power-ups. The fireball engulfs your arrow in a fireball, which does wide damage to your arrows, and it also can cut through multiple enemies. The bow extends your arrow's reach to be really far, aside from just this pissy little fire range. But this, ladies and gentlemen, is what I recommend taking the first time through every single time you find this room. This is the defense crystal. Unfortunately, we can't activate it at the moment because we don't have enough hit points. But once we get enough hit points, the defense crystal becomes almost necessary. Well, okay, it's not necessary, but it damn helps. Guys, there's the exit. I just gotta play my cards right. Yes! I'm home free, mother truckers! Woo! Holy crap! I honestly don't believe that I'm doing this well. This is incredible. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of the underworld, and we have reached the fortress. Oh, I love this stage. So, in the next part of Let's Attempt Kid Icarus up... No. In the next part of Let's Attempt Kid Icarus, we will be starting the first fortress, the Palace of Twin Bellows. Goodbye!